Hello everyone. In this video, I'm going to give you a very introductory session, but a very important session about different terms which we use regarding mechanical softwares or mechanical part simulations. So the three important terms to be starting with is sketching, modeling, and designing. So a note, we may change interchangeably use these words while we are talking with our friends. But while we go to industry, it will make sure that you have better concepts, your understanding is proper with these words is very important. When you communicate, these are going to be helpful to you. So to reduce communication gaps, these terms and understanding of these terms, the background of these terms are important. So let's start with these terms. First will be the sketching. So that is the first step into any designing of a part. Sketching is when you get some idea in your brain and you just try to put it down on your paper or some software. So over here, it is the first step of designing. If you have some ideas about how the shape of your mobile phone would be, would you put the edges, some rounds, some inserts, are there some different features? Even if for mechanical parts, you have some better ideas how a charger would look like, or how a mechanical pump could look like. What are different features? How can you give a handle, the length of the handle, the shape of the handle, etc. So that's all idea, whatever you have in your brain, when you put down on a paper or some software for your thought processes to make deeper and you can easily communicate with others. That is what comes in sketching. The very basic thing you should keep in mind right now while understanding this terms will be, take an example of a automobile, a sports car or a bicycle. So if you have some idea of how the length will be, how the hood will be, how the windows will be, how the handle will be of a car. So that's whatever idea you have got, you have put in on the paper. Maybe some lengths, some dimensions are included, whatever idea. So this is the most basic step, just a initial ideation step. Then the second step is the modeling step. So now you communicate your idea to some modeler who is going to put your ideas from paper into proper software where you will have some models like this. So these models will be more descriptive. There will be more information about the model when you go on some simulation softwares or modeling softwares such as AutoCAD, PTC, Creo, ANSYS, Space, Klim, SolidWorks, Fusion 360, etc. So these are the softwares where you can model something. So over here, you will have more information such as how the view will be in isometric side, front side, top side, side, sidewards, etc. What will be the lengths? And you can put some more features such as the rounds, chamfers, etc. to make it more attractive to people. But still, this is the second step. So this is a proper step in which you are going to, or it is going to help you to communicate your ideas from your brain effectively to your peers, because you have something which they can look at, the pictures which they can look at. This will help them to think of what you are talking about. So it's a more concrete step of ideation. Then the last step will be the designing, where you go on for how the materials will be, what will be the manufacturing process. So here you are going to think about more details of how it will come or become commercial or a physical object. So in between there can be prototypes and etc., but we are not talking in terms of what a product manager or product developer would think. This is purely with respect to what a mechanical part designer is going to think of. He will not talk or think about the commercialization. He just think of how can I manufacture that part. So he'll think about the material properties, what material to use, what will be the length, what will be the weight of that, what will be the design, the final design. So simulations are what we are going to simulate or replicate what is going to be in the real life. The structure is going to face weather conditions, some forces, etc. So whatever it is going to face, whatever expected forces are there in real life, we are going to translate them into a simulation software and check if my part is going to be able to sustain those forces, the weather condition, can it sustain for 5 years? Can it sustain for 10 years? For if forces are there, can a pen sustain a force of 1 Newton, 10 Newton, 100 Newton, 1000 Newton, etc.? So that's a simulation process. Then the optimization process comes. So over here, when we get some results, we may want to increase the stiffness of this pen so it doesn't bend easily. We may want to make it look lengthier to lengthen its life. The point may not be effective enough. It may stop working after 10 days of use. So I may want to increase its length to 100 days, etc. So that is optimization process where we may have to reduce the length, reduce the weight, increase the weight as per the need of the product. And this is a very complex process in which, as per the results you get from the simulation, if the body is very heavy and extra mass is there, we may go back to the model where we may go back to model and we may reduce the length. So that's what is done in the arms over here of the drone. The weight is removed. We can see the slots which are made over here. So that is because the extra mass was seen when we did simulations, and then some mass was removed. So that is weight topology optimization, after which also the part was safe enough when it is going to be loaded with the expected forces. And if that is going to be safe, so after this part becomes a part in the simulation, if it is safe enough, then the process is ending over there and we'll have a complete part. So these are the three different terms: sketching, modeling, designing. And another important term which I didn't stress much upon was simulation. But simulation is also very whole and soul term or whole and soul process in designing. So that is a complete picture for you. So that's all I have to say over here. In the next videos, we can go into more details of using the software itself. So thank you.